Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video I start to make a fixture for grinding circular saw blades. I also show how to set up the forge or chuck for turning and a simple device for setting your tool on centerline. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. This is my DeWalt radial arm saw and I want to remove the blade to sharpen it. This blade has 24 carbide tips and is 10 inches in diameter. This is my tool and cutter grinder. It's a Worden. And what I want to do is make something so I can hold the blade here and just grind the tip, the outer diameter, across the wheel. So it needs something in the middle here to hold the blade flat so I can rotate it in the middle and grind each tip. So if I can set the blade in that position and just move it backwards and forwards like that in front of the grinding wheel, move it inwards and just take a cut, then pull it off, rotate it round to the next one, move it back in. I need to make something in the middle of the blade that will centralise it, which I can rotate the saw blade on, and something that will locate each tooth in front of the grinding wheel ready for grinding. The first thing I need to do is take the chuck off. As always, I put a piece of wood on the bed just in case I drop that chuck. I don't want to damage the bed. Turn the chuck around so the spindle lock's engaged. Put a bar through the top, just tap it and unscrew the chuck. If I did drop it, there's no damage to the bed. If I thread a brush, move any bits out, put that on the bed, clean the thread inside, just in case any bits of swarf have fallen through, and the face. Should be able to fit on. Spindle lock on again, just tap, and I'll just nip that just to hold it. I'm going to leave the wood there just in case it drops. Okay, I'm fitting my dial indicator in the tool post, wind this in, and I'll just come up to the end here, see how much this is running out. Not bad for a guess, it's 35 thou. This is the highest one, the one that's come towards us the furthest, so that needs tightening. Take that one in a bit. About 15 thou. So I can't tighten these any tighter without putting a lot of load on. So what you do now, this is the highest point here, this one. So take the one at the back opposite, just slacken this off fraction, and then tighten the front one up. Okay, just turn that round again. That's about half a thou run out. And before I start cutting, I just want to make sure that all the jaws are tight. This is my tool height gauge. All it is take it apart, three pieces, a spacer that goes on the dial indicator. This has got a recess there just so that the bevel edge of the indicator misses. And another spacer. Now this one has got a flat surface at the bottom and the top, and they're parallel. And that goes over the dial indicator. I and locks on this face, with the dial indicator protruding just a bit, just as long as the dial indicator can move, that's okay. That goes on the face, and just set the zero roughly. So that's ready to be used. So all I do is slacken the tool post off, turn the tool round, so then what we do is, if the tool's at centre height, it will just go under this lip. You can see there that the tool is above centre height, so I need to lower the tool down until I can get the dial indicator over the top of the tool. Now I'm just tightening the tool post up slightly so the tool can still move, so that goes over the top. Now as I wind the tool up by using the adjuster, when that dial indicator moves, which is there, I know the top of that tool is level with this, which is exactly on centre line to the chuck. I just want to take a light cut across the face. No pip. Well, that fits on there. What I need to do is take the radius out the corner, change my tool for this one, see if I'm getting the corner. That goes on and it touches the face behind, so that's okay. I've reset my tool at an angle so I can put a slight chamfer on that edge. That will give the blade a lead. So the next job is to drill and tap this, a 6mm tap in the end. Thank you. I've chased my parting off tool, and now I'm just setting up to the right distance. I've zeroed on this face. I want this thickness to be 25 mil to the outside of the tool. So the width of the tool, 3 mil. Up the tool at that. So I'll start the machine off. That's running at 200 RPM. See how that cuts. Slow it down. So I slowed it right down. It's only doing 96 RPM. But as I go in further, I'll start to speed it up. It's cutting well at that. It's not vibrating too much. I'm slowly increasing the speed as I'm going in. This is the top slide on the cutter grinder. This is a piece we've just made. And you can see here, the screw hits the block, and this pushes it too far out. So I want to cut some of that metal away like this, about a quarter of an inch deep, so it misses this screw, and this area here will come over the top of this block. That's the top for there. That goes on okay. There's just a little gap so I can get the saw blade on there. The top goes on. So we're going over to the milling machine to mill some of this away. You may have noticed at first this was a blue tool, just snapped off. So this is a carbide tool, done down to the red line. Now I'm going over to the other line and bring that down to the same level. All I have to do now is mill a slot along there to clear the thread. I've changed to an 8mm milling cutter. This is the original tool cutter grinder slide. I've taken the slider I use for radius turning, which is this bit, that can stay on. I've held the block on with a cap head through the slide from underneath into the block. That can go there, and that screws up to the end. And the blade goes on top of this. Oh well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Hope it was interesting. And we'll finish this next time on Enots Engineering.